Einsteinium, nobelium, and arc, kryptonium, radon, xenon, zinc, and rhodium, and chlorine, carbon.
Carbon, 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 carbon! The most widely used technique used to prepare graphene is the scotch tape technique. You need to wear gloves and goggles for this procedure. First, you take a piece of scotch tape and place a flake of graphite in the center. Then, fold the tape over the flake and slowly peel it back apart so that the flake is cleaved in two. Repeat this process. Next, take a silicon wafer and place it on the tape. Rub the graphite onto the wafer and peel the tape off gently. The wafer is now ready to go through an optical technique and confocal Raman spectroscopy.
Experiments have shown that when using white light, graphene is best detected on a silicon wafer topped with a silicon oxide layer approximately 300 nanometers thick. This specific thickness produces a bluish-purple tint, so the one on the right has a silicon oxide layer. If a plain silicon wafer with no silicon oxide layer is used in the experiment, the distinctive colors of graphite and graphene can't be observed. In order to qualitatively determine the location of the graphene, you can use an optical microscope. The lens in this microscope has a magnification power of 100. Once you place a silicon wafer under the scope, you can hunt for the graphene as if you're searching for an island in the sea. Most of the stuff you see on the screen is tape residue. Graphene can be distinguished by its sharp edges. It typically takes a long time to find a suitable sample. Here, we have sped up and skipped hours of diligent work for your viewing pleasure. The dark green areas are probably the best candidates for graphene. Here, we are switching to 100 times magnification. Now, you can see the difference between multiple layers and single layers. The single layers are almost transparent, while the multiple layers are thicker and dark brown. Here, we have repeated the experiment with a regular silicon wafer without a silicon oxide layer. As you can observe, you can no longer discern the different shades that distinguish single layers from multiple layers. Again, you can see that the sharp edges distinguish graphite flakes from tape residue.
Although the optical technique is the easiest to use and the most widely accessible, it is still only qualitative speculation. To confirm that the layers are actually graphene, we need to use confocal Raman spectroscopy. Once you have found what you believe to be graphene from the optical technique, you need a high-intensity laser to do some fancy experiments called confocal Raman spectroscopy. This is a form of lighted digital imaging, where a laser is focused on a single point. If the incidental wavelength or color of the laser is the same as what comes out, aka scattered light, it is known as elastic scattering. Inelastic scattering, aka Raman scattering, is when the wavelength of the scattered light is different. A spectrum analysis of the light intensity and wavelength can quantitatively determine whether there is a single layer or multiple layers. There are two important peaks in the graph, the G-band and the 2D band. If the 2D band is very pointy and taller than the G-band, it is a graph depicting graphene. As the number of layers of the sample increase, the 2D band gets shorter and wider.
Gotta get dip. Gotta get dip. Gotta get dip. Gotta get dip, 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 dip.